Welcome to our TeamGuru tutorial, how to create a metric dashboard. Metric dashboard helps you to track your KPIs, analyze performance, and manage corrective actions through interlinked documents. To get started, please click on Metric Dashboards module in the left panel. Then select a folder from your organization structure in which you would like to create this dashboard and click green plus button to create your new document. And now you are ready to define your metric dashboard settings. You can enter the title, add labels if applicable, choose your responsible person. Dashboard template is optional and it will be covered in a different video tutorial. However, this is a great option if you need to create several dashboards with the same settings and metrics. Once the dashboard template is created in the system, you will be able to choose from the existing options. And now we can move to individual tabs. Interval, here you will choose what is the default view when you open your dashboard. In this case, you will see a monthly view. Under default view, you define which month should be activated when you open your dashboard. If you choose last, that means you will see previous month. Under displayed period, you have several options to choose from how you're going to view your time period in your dashboard. And here, if you are setting up a weekly interval, you also have to assign weeks to your fiscal calendar and you choose from these options. When you are setting up a monthly view, you don't need to set that up. Next, you will be setting up your view options. Under show time periods in columns, for dashboards with multiple objects, you can choose this option to display time periods in columns, or you can leave unchecked to display metrics in the columns. And then you have also options to choose to group it by metrics or by units. Next, you have option to organize your metrics in groups according to your metric groups, such as quality, safety, delivery, and so on. You can also decide if you would like to show weekdays only in your dashboard or full length names of your sites from the organizational structure. Under row layout, here you can choose which rows you would like to see in your dashboard. Actual values, plan values, change from prior year, and so on. You can also display comments in your dashboard. However, the comment column can be displayed only in views with time periods. You can set up a dashboard description, which is optional. You can add any simple text or even add a link, and it will be displayed right here in your dashboard. Under default metric setting, you are able to select the fields you would like to additionally see in your dashboard. For example, year-to-date data that will be calculated automatically, quarter-to-date, and so on. You can also show summary row. Summary row you use in case you would like to calculate sum or average for your entities in your dashboard and you don't want to necessarily create roll-up summary calculation. In that case, you will make a choice if it's sum or average, whichever makes sense, and then you will see the row in your dashboard. You can also hide values in case you would like to show color coding only, choose your column width. Under require RCCA AD, you can set up your alerts that will be displayed in your dashboard and they will be triggered by certain conditions. For example, when the goal is not met, either every time or how many times in a row. And you can find more information regarding RCCA and AD alerts on our support website. And now we move on to the next step, dashboard setup. And here you will be setting up what metrics you would like to collect for which objects. To add a new object, you will scroll down and click green plus button to add object. And here you will see that in the submenu you have several options to collect data for org units, action lists, partners, and so on. So you will choose your object. You can also choose the responsible for that particular object. And you have some display options to choose from. And once you make your selection, you will click Add. To add a metric, you will click green plus button in the right upper corner, add metric. And here you have option to either choose from already existing metrics in the system, or you can also create a new metric directly from here. Please note, to create new metrics in the system that requires a sufficient right, and usually your system administrators can help you with that. Next, you have an option to choose among different settings for your metrics in the dashboard. You can use the default view, dashboard default, which is the settings that you set up under basic settings tab. You can also choose simple. Simple settings helps you to change default setting for specific metric in your dashboard. And next settings, advanced beta. That is more complex settings, and we are not going to cover details in this video tutorial. Basically, it helps you to customize your metric settings in the dashboard, and then you can display more columns and rows per your needs. For example, you can view calculated values without creating a new metric. For example, if you would like to compare actual versus plans and so on. And you can also display your project header information for project dashboards. But please visit our support website for more information, or don't hesitate to contact our team and we would be happy to assist you to set it up. To sort your object and metrics in a dashboard, you can use drag and drop functionality. You can also right click on your object and choose from these options. The same goes for your metrics, drag and drop, right click. If you want to assign responsible for your object, you just have to left click on your object, and here you can choose your responsible, you can choose display options or remove it if needed, and then you will see the initials of your responsible right here. If you want to assign responsible for object and metric combination, you have to click into that cell, assign the responsible. And once you do, you will see the responsible's initials right here. And you can also expand and collapse objects in your dashboard. This will be the default settings for the dashboard data view and email subscription, but you are also able to expand and collapse in a dashboard view. When you click on minus, it will collapse. When you click plus, it will expand your objects. And to be able to collapse or expand, you just have to drag and drop your objects under your main folder. And there are a few more items to mention under Dashboard Setup tab. You are also able to view your objects and metrics in compact view or full screen view. And all the way on the bottom, there is also option to tick the box automatically generate units that contain actual metrics values. We are not going to go into details in this video tutorial. However, you can find more information on our support website. And just shortly, you are basically able to create automatic dashboards that will populate data for your objects automatically based on certain criteria. And now we can move on to the next tab, access and location. In this tab, you set up access type. If you would like to share your document with public, which means that whoever has access to this folder will be able to view your document, but you can also lock your document and make it accessible for only invited people. In that case, you will choose users from the submenu. You can also protect settings of your dashboard, and only responsible and document administrators will be able to modify settings of your dashboard. Document location, here you will choose folder or folders in which you would like to display your dashboard. And you are also able to share your dashboard with external partners, and in that case you will choose the partner in the submenu. And now we can go to the next tab, related documents. Under related documents tab, you can add documents that are related to your dashboard. You can add either existing documents from any other module in the system, or you can create a new one. Here you will be also able to add external link. And if you would need to get to those related documents easily, you can just click on related documents button in the right upper corner above your dashboard, and those are live links, so you will be able to get to those documents fast and easy. Next, subscriptions tab. Here you can subscribe users to receive email with your dashboard document in several different attachments, either PDF or Excel file. Here are already some users subscribed. To add new subscription, click green plus button. Here you can subscribe either single user or user group. You will choose the time period when the email is going to be sent. And here you will choose if you would like to see it as a PDF attachment, document snapshot, Excel attachment, and so on. And you can choose other criteria. Once you are done with that setup, you will click save and close. Next tab, notifications. Here you can sign up users to receive automatic email notifications, either about data entry reminder, overdue notification, or RCCA reminders. And here you will see that you are able to choose to send this email either to dashboard responsible or unit responsible or both, and other people also. Here you will select the time. Next, history tab. Here you will find a full history log of any changes done to your dashboard. You can search by user, you can search in data history. Here you also have an option to export it to Excel. And once you are done with all the settings of your dashboard, you click save and return button. And now you build your dashboard. Here you will see the title of your dashboard, responsible person, if you added any labels. You can also filter and sort by either objects or metrics in your dashboard. Here in this view, you will see your objects, your sites on the left side. On the top, you will see your metrics and metric groups. You can switch the time period of your dashboard view if you would like to see daily, weekly, or monthly values. You can show and hide dashboard's description. You can see your dashboard as data view, but you can also switch to charts view and spreadsheet view. Spreadsheet view is a great functionality when you can easily copy and paste your data to your dashboard. On the right side, you can also see comments, actions, or attachments in the side panel. And here are more features. You can view performance statistics when you click on this icon. You can also add labels this way if needed. Choose the title of the label, color, and add. You can view more details and definition of your metric when you click on the eye icon. In your dashboard, you can also see any attachments right here. When you hover over it and click on it, it will give you the comment, for example. If it's an attachment of a different document, you will be able to get to that document through the live link. And you can also see trend chart when you click on the arrow. And there are other options. You can get to your previous document from here. You can view your related documents. Click on the live link, as I mentioned before. Under three dots, you will have other options to choose from. You can, for example, add your dashboard document to your favorites. In that case, you will find it in the left corner and you just click on it and get to it. You have several options to choose from for the export. For your dashboard, you can start full view presentation, zoom in and out as needed. As you can see, data values in your dashboard can be color-coded, that is set up in a metric settings. If you need to enter data, you simply click into the cell of combination of your metric and object and enter the values. In TeamGuru, you can set up several types of calculations for your metric. It can be either roll-up calculation, so your daily values, for example, to weekly, to monthly. You can also set up calculations when you need to, for example, calculate values for region from several sites. That's a summary calculations. And also formula calculations when you would like to, for example, calculate OTTR from different input metrics. The calculated values, it's in italic format in your dashboard. And if you need to see how it is calculated, when you click on it and go to your related metrics, you will see how it is calculated. And a few more features before we finish today. When you click on certain object, you will be able to just view the data for that object. When you hover over the metrics, there are other options to choose from. Please note that you need to have a sufficient rights to use this. Once again, there is the metric details definition, mass data entry. In this case, you will be able to choose which org units in the dashboard you would like to enter data for, the time period, value, and so on. Once again, this is covered in our support website, and you have to have a sufficient rights. You can add that label and see the statistics. And this is pretty much it. If you have any questions or need any assistance, please don't hesitate to contact us at support@teamguru.com. We would be very happy to hear from you.